Dear students, this is Afsana Awal. Today I will take you DCS class. And students, today's topic is chapter 11, CQ 1 and 2. So let's start our class, students. At first, this loop, we have two CQ here, that means two creative questions here. The first one is, Anindo, along with his parents, went to visit a neighboring country during the summer vacation. It has the Himalayas at its north and the Hindu Kush and Sulaiman Mountains at its west. The country is rich in ancient art and civilization. The first question, what is the name of capital city of Malaysia? Number B, what do you understand by a multi-ethnic country? Discuss. Number C, describe the similarity in climate between Bangladesh and the country visited by Anindo. Number D, explain the importance of friendship and cooperation between Bangladesh and the country visited by Anindo. And this is the second question, that event one, Mr. Shofil went to visit a country of Southeast Asia. Natural sights of this country surrounded by sea are very beautiful. Though the country is island based, four islands mainly constitute their economy. Event 2. Mr. Kobe has long been serving in an East Asian country. Though the country has got the highest population on earth, it is also rich in its economy. What is the name of the largest mountain chain on earth? Number B, explain why India is known as rich in ancient civilization. Number C, what kind of climate is available in the country Mr. Shofil went to? Describe. Number D, give a comparative study of the two economies described in events 1 and 2. So start here. Number 1, A is Kuala Lumpur is the capital of Malaysia. Number 2 question is, what do you understand by a multi-ethnic country? Discuss. A multi-ethnic country consists of various groups of races or ethnicities. As an example, India, a powerful country of South Asia, can be mentioned. In this country, people of many religions, Hindus, Muslims, Buddhists, Christians, Sikhs, Jains, etc. live together. China, a country of East Asia, is also a multiracial country. This is because people of different races and ethnicities live there. Now go to the question number C. Describe the similarity in climate between Bangladesh and the country visited by Anindo. Students, just one thing you have to mention here. Anindo went to visit India. He compared the climate of India to that of Bangladesh. Some of these comparisons are discussed below. It is actually, in the case of comparison, you can write here similarities. Students, you can write here some of the similarities are discussed below. Number 1. Summers are hot and humid in both countries. Number 2. Winters are generally dry in both countries. Both countries experience heavy rainfall during the monsoon season. Number 4. Both India and Bangladesh have been blessed with many rivers. Number 5. Both countries have fertile land, hence agriculture is very important and productive sector. Number 6. India's climate can be classified as hot tropical except the northern states. Now number D. India and Bangladesh share a unique bond and a special relationship rooted in a common cultural heritage and shared principles and values. India was the second country to recognize Bangladesh as a separate and independent state and establish diplomatic relation with the country immediately after its independence in December 1971. India played a vital role in the liberation war of Bangladesh. However, relations between the two neighboring countries have not always been cordial. Issues concerning land, water, illegal migration, and border security have cropped up from time to time. India and Bangladesh share a border over 4,000 kilometers. At present, Indo-Bangladesh relations are friendly and have certainly witnessed a significant upswing over the past decade. Now, the answer of question number two. First answer, number A, the name of the largest mountain chain in the world is Himalayas. Number B, India is known as rich in ancient civilization. Marks of civilization of nearly 5,000 years old. Students, you can write here Z and S also as you wish. I have written here Z. Civilization of nearly 5,000 years old have been found in this country. Cave drawings of Ajanta in South India, innumerable temples and sculptures spread all over the country, Taj Mahal of Agra, Qutub Minar and Red Fort of Delhi, etc. bear the mark of ancient civilizations of India. Now, number C, we can realize that Mr. Schofield visited Japan. The climate of Japan is temperate. The country consists of about 4,000 islands. The sea is on all four sides of the country. Effect of monsoon is clear in the northeast part of Japan. The summer is humid and the winter is moderately cold. For this type of climate, paddy, wheat, barley, soybean, sweet potato, sugar cane, beet, apple and grapes are grown here. Number D, in the incident 1, Mr. Schofield visited Japan, and in the incident 2, Mr. Kovir visited China. These two countries have two different economic systems, though both are economically developed. Japan is a capitalist country and China follows socialist economic system. The Chinese economy is still mainly agro-based, but Japan is an industrially developed country. These two countries have some common agricultural products like paddy, wheat, potato, soybean, sugarcane, etc. Tea, cotton, tobacco, etc. grow very well in China and play an important role in the Chinese economy. On the contrary, Japan has made amazing progress in industrial sector. The main industries of Japan are iron and steel, electronics, shipbuilding and automobile, textile, machinery, medicine, electric ware, and various heavy machineries. The main industries of China are iron, steel, silk, fertilizer, machinery, cement, paper, medicine, etc. Both countries have some valuable mineral resources like petroleum, coal, gold, etc. Japan has a good amount of natural gas. Student, now just look, your HW is CQ1, A and B. This is your HW and you have to submit it. Okay students, now that's all for today. Take care, stay safe, stay well. Allah Hafiz.